Okay, that's right. You guessed it. In today's video, I'm going to be going over what is a joule. And this is the second in a series of three videos that I'm going to make about what is a newton, what is a joule, and what is a watt. Because as you know, the newton is the metric unit for the force, which a force is a push or a pull. The joule is the metric unit for work or energy. And when you apply a force through a certain distance, then you do work. And when you do that work over a certain amount of time, then you have power, and the metric unit for power is the watt, and power is like the rate at which work is done or how fast work is done. But today's video is going to be about the joule, which is the metric unit for work and energy. Like I just said, the joule is the derived unit for work or energy in the metric system. Now, it just says derived there because it's not the base unit, because the joule is a newton meter. That just means it's derived. There's other units kind of inside the joule, which we'll talk about in a moment. But the joule is the metric unit for work and also for energy. And it is equal. This is what one joule is. It is equal to the work done on an object, or the energy transferred to an object. We have to say kind of the work done on an object. We kind of have to specify to what object we're transferring the energy, or we do work on an object when a force of 1 newton is applied through a distance of 1 meter. So it's the work done on an object when a force of 1 newton is applied through a distance of 1 meter. And oftentimes you'll see that it's the work required to produce 1 watt of power for 1 second. This is often used for like electricity and for light bulbs, which are rated in watts. Okay, but a joule is what we'd say is a newton meter. So like we said in the previous slide, if you apply a force of 1 newton through a distance of 1 meter, then you do 1 joule of work. The abbreviation for the joule is the capital J. And that is the metric unit for power. So we say the equation symbol. Okay, excuse me, not the metric unit for power, it's the metric unit for work and energy. So the equation symbol for work is work, and the abbreviation for that is W. And we can write it like this. So when we kind of put together the equation symbol and the abbreviation for the unit, we could say that we do, on an object, 120 joules of work. When we calculate the amount of work done, it's calculated as the force times the distance. You can see that right here, the force times the distance. It's a newton meter. So it's a force that you apply and the distance through which that force is applied. Just multiply those two numbers together. So like we said up here, there's 120 joules of work. There's, of course, an infinite way that you could do 120 joules of work. One way you could do 120 joules of work is if you apply a force of 120 newtons over a distance of 1 meter. Okay, and you can see that if we multiply 120 times 1, we get 120 joules. Or, obviously, you could also, another possibility of the endless possibilities is if you apply a force of 10 newtons over a distance of 12 meters, because 10 times 12 is also 120. Okay, so obviously there's an infinite number, but that's how you calculate the amount of work that you do. It's the force times the distance. It's not the force over the distance because it's a newton meter. It's not a newton per meter. All right? That is a joule. Now, where do we get that from? We get that from this guy whose name is James Prescott Joule. He lived from 1888 to 1889, and he did a lot of work with work and energy and energy transfer. Excuse me. And one thing he had was this device, which this demonstrated the mechanical equivalent of heat. And it said that whenever a mechanical force is expanded, an exact equivalent of heat is always obtained. So this is a device that he came up with around 1845. There's a little pulley wheel here. There's this mass that's going to fall. It's going to pull on this string, and this string is going to pull on this piece of wood here, and it's going to turn, and this is in water. This is a little vessel in water. There's these paddles in here, and there's a thermometer here. So when this falls down, okay, when mechanical force is expended by pulling this down, then the water will be heated up by an equivalent amount of heat or by temperature that would represent an equivalent amount of heat that would be transferred to the water. He could measure the temperature of the water very precisely. And it's also had to do with specific heat and the joules and 4.184, the specific heat of water, joules per kilogram, per joules per gram per degree Celsius. But he was able to demonstrate that when this fell and work was done on this object, then the equivalent amount of heat was transferred to the water. Okay? And that was James Prescott Joule, and therefore he got the unit named after him. Now, it's always good, in the previous video, which you can link to in the upper right-hand corner of this video, I try to talk about what, you know, how do you apply one newton of force, and then now I'm going to try and show you how you do one joule of work. Okay, well, how you do one joule of work is it's the work done to lift approximately 100 grams, that's 102 grams, which is 0.102 kilograms through a distance of 1 meter. Because a mass of 100 grams or 102 grams has a gravitational force or a weight of 1 newton. So here I have, this is 50 grams, this is 50 grams, and this hanger is actually 10 grams, but we could just call this 100 grams approximately. If I take this mass and I hold it like this, it's applying a force of 1 newton down through the gravitational attraction to Earth. That means I have to apply a force of 1 newton up to hold it steady like that. And if I take that object and I lift it or I raise it up through a distance of 1 meter, like if it was on the floor, I lift it on the table and the table is a meter above the ground, then I'm doing 1 joule of work. Take that 100 gram object, lift it through 1 meter, and that's a joule of work. That's how you do 1 joule of work. Okay? Now, we said it's just the force times the distance. And because the force of this is the mass times the acceleration due to gravity, we can calculate the amount of work we do when we lift something up against gravity. You could also just push or pull something, but when we're lifting something up, we take the mass times the acceleration due to gravity times the distance of 1 meter. So the mass I said was 0.12 kilograms. All this has to be in kilograms in the mass. That's the base unit for mass in the metric system. The acceleration due to gravity at the surface of the Earth is 9.81 meters per second squared. I lift that through a distance of 1 meter, and I get that the amount of work that I do is 1 joule. Okay, that's 1 joule of work. So let's just kind of give another example. When you're lifting something against gravity, and this is, of course, how much work do I do on my body? So when I lift myself and I do a pull-up, I'm doing work on my body, all right, when I do one pull-up. Now, I'm going to assume that when I do one pull-up, I raise my body up about 60 centimeters, and the mass of my body is approximately 95 kilograms, depending on what's going on. So let's just say that we're going to calculate the amount of work we do. The work is the force times the distance. The force we calculate as the mass of the object, basically times 9.81, that's basically my weight. This becomes my weight in newtons. And then the distance. So I have a mass of 95 kilograms. The acceleration due to gravity is 9.81 meters per second squared. I lift that a distance of 60 centimeters, which this has to be converted into meters. That's 0.6 meters. And that means when I do one pull-up, I do 560 joules of work. Okay, so there you go. That is what a joule is. It's a newton meter. It's when you apply a force through a distance, a force of 1 newton through a distance of 1 meter. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you found the video helpful. If you did, please do all the following 4 things. It helps me out a lot. First, you should give me a thumbs up for this video. Then you should leave me a nice positive comment in the comment section below. And don't forget, sharing is caring. Share this video with all of your friends. And then please subscribe. Subscribe to my video, to my channel, and get all my excellent physics, chemistry, and math videos. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video.